into cell life cycle, mitosis, also with prokaryotes. We're going to talk a little bit about what's called binary fissures. So here's my little joke of the day. Biology. Only science where multiplication and division mean the same thing, right? Mitosis. Kind of a catchy thing. Alright, so let's get into the cell life cycle and then we'll get into mitosis. So this is the cell dividing. Alright? So the cell life cycle, we have something called interphase. That is not a part of mitosis. And I've heard a lot of teachers, at least when I was in high school, a little bit in college too, that interphase is the resting phase. That is anything but true. Alright? In fact, the interphase, they're doing more things in there than in mitosis. Interphase is when what you just learned about with DNA replication, that's when that happens, stored interphase. You're going to have proteins that are being multiplied, or not just multiplied, they're going to be made during that time. Also, if we're going to get preparation of this mitosis splitting one cell into two, well, you've got to make duplicates of mitochondria and all the different organelles in there to split into two. So just keep in mind, the interphase is not the resting phase. There is no resting phase. I thought maybe it was like a G0, but I wouldn't even call it resting phase. They're doing stuff in there. Okay? So that's what's happening. Mitosis is the time where the cell needs to divide into two. Okay? There's a life cycle of every cell. The life cycle could be lasting like, in a few hours that it needs to make, two more. Or it could be, like I said, about 70 years. That's your muscles and your nervous system. Not nervous system, but neurons and these nerve cells. They take quite a long time to divide. We're talking about decades. Okay? And then cytokinesis is like the last part of mitosis. It happens normally called telophase. And it's basically the time when the cytoplasm is going to split into two. So you've got the cytosol and all the organelles that are going to split into two. So when we break up the cell cycle, we break it up in this way. If let's say, and I'm just giving you numbers, okay, just so you can visualize what's going on here. If you're looking at, let's say, a certain cell cycle, and it's going to take, let's say, an hour to go through a cell cycle, all right? Like I said, it could be 7 hours, it could be 70 years, but just run in the mill, I'm just giving you, you're looking at this like a clock. What you're looking at is maybe 45 minutes is going to be in the green, which is interphase, and the only last part, the last 15 minutes, which is in yellow over here, is going to be mitosis, where the cell is actually going to divide. So most of the time, it's going to be an interphase, it's going to happen during interphase, okay? Now, when you look at the interphase itself, you can break that down into three sections. Alright, we call it G1, S, and then G2. And during those phases of interphase, G1, that's where the duplication of organelles is going to take place. During the S phase, that's when the DNA replication takes place. The thing that you've been learning about with Akazaki fragments and all that stuff. And then G2 is where you're going to have all the proteins going to be made that the cell has to make. Alright? Keep in mind, things where, let's say, if a bacteria comes inside the cell and the cell has to fight it off, it's going to happen anywhere in there, right? So we've got to have guards and police officers doing their job then. But then we have this yellow area, which is going to be mitosis, when the cell divides. Okay? And there's four phases to that. Prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. Okay? And there's certain things that the cell nucleus is going to go through, and each one of those phases will tell you what the nucleus is going through. So this is just a close-up showing that, that thing I was showing you before. Okay? You can take a look at that. All right, so let's talk about mitosis, at least in eukaryotic cells. All right, ones that have membranes. So this is what's going to happen. I think I showed this before. In order for us to get from one cell to turn into two identical cells split into two, it has to go through a number of phases. First off, we need to duplicate the DNA, which is what you learned from before. That's why I wanted you to learn that before we get into mitosis. Okay? So this happens during interphase. Okay? Once we duplicate it, now it looks like the X's that you've seen, the chromosomes, and they're only showing two here. We really have 46 pairs, right? Then it's got to go through a series of phases to split into two. Now here's the thing, because we're going to get into meiosis in probably next week or the week after, whichever. But here's the major thing about mitosis. You get two daughter cells, we call these daughter cells, two daughter cells that are identical to each other, and they're identical with the what we call the parent cell. Okay? That's different when we get into meiosis. You're going to have to compare and contrast those two. Let's just talk about mitosis. You get two identical daughter cells that are also identical with the original parent cell. Okay? Alright, so let's go through these phases. Alright? I'm not so big about things called pro-metaphase. Is that late metaphase? Is it early? Late prophase? Is it early metaphase? I'm not going to go into that, all right? You'll see it in the book. To me, it gets a little bit confusing because you have two answers for the same thing. So what we're saying here is prophase. Early, late, all right, just prophase in general. And what's going to happen here is that, well, let me start doing my little drawing here. What you're going to happen, it's hard, when I draw this, I'm going to do a lot of animation as I'm drawing it, which means I'm going to erase things and draw some things. So I'm just giving you guys a heads up. If you're going to be drawing it with me, I'm going to frustrate you because you drew it in pen and then I'm erasing things and now you've got to erase it too. So you might want to just keep an eye on here and I'll go through the slides. So you have this cell. Alright? And in the cell you have the nucleus. Alright? I'm kind of drawing it bigger than usual just so people in the back can see. And what we have is chromatin that's all in here. You know what? I'll put it in purple. So chromatin is all in here. You really can't see it. It looks like hair. You can't see it, right? It's uncoiled DNA. And you also have on the sides over here, centrioles, right? You got a pair there, and we have a pair there. Okay? Now what's going to happen here in prophase is a few different things. The nuclear membrane, well first off, these chromosomes are going to start turning, I'm sorry, this chromatin is going to turn into chromosomes. They're going to start condensing. So you're going to start seeing this forming in those chromosomes that we talked about before. So that's one of the things that's happening in prophase is that the chromatin is condensed and turned to chromosomes. Also, you're going to see that these centrioles are going to move on opposite poles of the nucleus. So now they're over here and over here. Also, the nuclear envelope is going to start disappearing. See, I got animation going on. Right. Okay. So that's what we have at the end of prophase. Okay. Questions about that? Okay. So, what's going to happen next? I'm trying to show you on here. So this is all prophase, right? So here's your cell, there's your nucleus, there's your centrioles over here, two pairs. The centrioles, the chromosomes start forming from the chromatin. It there, you'll also see that the centrioles are going to go on opposite sides of the nucleus, and the nuclear membrane starts breaking down. Okay, so far so good. All right, now what's going to happen here? The next phase is called metaphase. These centrioles start forming what we call spindles. Okay? And they start forming spindles and they attach themselves to the chromosomes on either side. They pull like there's a tug of war, and it's a standstill. What's going to happen is, as they pull back and forth, these chromosomes are going to start lining up in the center. So they start doing this. Spindles on here, and they kind of pull it like a tug of war, but they line in the center. Best way I can explain what this is, I don't know if you know what a marionette puppet is, where you have the handle up here and the strings come down, and then they're on the puppet, like Pinocchio, like you've seen Pinocchio? I got no strings to hold me up. You know what I'm saying, right? All right. So think of the handle is the centrioles. The spindle fibers that are coming off here, also asters, they're the strings, and then the chromosomes are actually the puppet. Alright? So they have control about which way they're going. Does that make sense? Okay? And they kind of line themselves right in the center, like an imaginary disc is there. Okay? That's what happens in metaphase. The next part is something called anaphase. And what anaphase is that these chromosome pairs are going to split with each other. Because they're duplicates, right? Remember, we duplicated that. This is really one chromosome. I'm sorry, one DNA over here. But we duplicated it. So there's going to be another one here. Right? We learned how to duplicate it. So we've got to split them. And what's going to happen here is the next phase is anaphase. phase, they start splitting. Kind of look like this. All right. Why they're looking like these over here is because of the way this whole cytosol in here. And it kind of like looks like weird, but let's say I'm a chromosome. So if there's like something that's pulling me, right? Centromere over here, it's connected here. There's a wire that's trying to pull me. My arms, like a chromosome, will they go like this? That makes sense. But you see what I mean? My arms kind of go back like that. That's what's happening over here. That's why they're looking that way. They're pulling it by the centromere, and then the arms themselves are going back. And that's how you'll see it. The arms are kind of facing each other. And you'll be able to see that with anaphase. Alright, questions about that? Alright, so that's anaphase. The centromeres split and they kind of get pulled from each other, going to opposite sides. Now, telophase is the last phase that's going on here, and what's going to happen is a few things. First off, the cell itself is going to start pinching off. And in fact, there's something called a furrow, where it's not quite split into two, but you're going to see some where the area where it's going to split. It's called a furrow. I'll show you what that looks like. And these chromosomes are going to be pushed up over here further. Nuclear membrane is going to reform. And the chromosomes are now going to go back to chromatin. And that's what happens in telophase. What will happen on afterwards is basically once this splits into two, now telophase is over, you got two separate cells. Cytokinesis is happening during telophase, the end part of telophase, where it's going to be making 50% of the cytoplasm here and 50% of the cytoplasm here. There's going to be 50% of our mitochondria here, 50% over here, 50% of Golgi apparatus over here, 50% over here. That's cytokinesis. What we've been talking about with mitosis is really separating the nuclei. So here's the completion of it. So here's the metaphase, where the chromosomes are all lined up in the center. Spindle fibers are all there, pulling them. And now during anaphase, they're really pulling them, the homologs, we call them chromosome homologs, the sisters, so to say. So that we have our one sisters on this side and one sisters on that side, right? So that's going to be anaphase, and then during telophase, you're going to see it pinching off like that. You'll see this furrow in the center over there. That's going to also help you to depict that this is going to be telophase. And then the nucleolus and the nucleus are starting to reform with as the chromosomes turn back to chromatin, and the nuclear envelope starts redeveloping on either of those daughter cells. Okay, questions about that? All right, so my little mnemonic, I wouldn't even call it a mnemonic. I mean, I just call it IPMAP, right? Interphase, prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. Okay? We're going to be be in the lab, we're going to be looking at whitefish, and they have a scale. We look at the cells of them, and we also have onion roots. And you're going to see the many different phases. What's the most common phase you're going to see all over there? Interphase, right? Because that's where most of the time it's going to spend. The only time you're going to see actually chromosomes is during mitosis, and it's such a short time. Okay? But they're kind of showing you what they kind of look like, right? There's interphase, prophase, they're starting to turn into chromosomes. All right, metaphase, they're kind of all lined up in the center. They're being split in anaphase. And here's telophase. See, there's that furrow I was trying to explain to you, right? It's not quite two separate cells, but you can definitely see that there's a furrow there. I'm going to turn off the light completely. This is what I took with my camera on the what you'll be seeing. That cell right there, these are all interphases over here. But this one over here is still one cell. What phase do you think that is? Think about it. You see a furrow there? No, there's no furrow there. You see the chromosomes being pulled at either side. So what is this? Anaphase. Good. Okay. Here's another one. Look at that. What do you think that is? Metaphase, right, that's beautiful. That's my fireplace mantle. Guys, all right, it's early. All right, but that's metaphase, okay? And these are ones that you can just do on your own. All the different phases, all right, and there's the answers to them all, so you can do it on your own. What I want to show you quickly is kind of making a virtual microscope. Okay, so in the lab, like I said, we have the onion root where you can see certain mitosis phases, or mitotic phases. We also have the whitefish, and I think we have the reason why we got two different ones is that certain, the whitefish shows metaphase a little bit better than the other ones, or than the onion, and the onion might show some of the phases better than the whitefish. So my suggestion is definitely take a look at them. You will need to identify them, hint, hint, for future exams and quizzes, okay? You need to identify those. You won't have to find them, they'll already be there. We have some models in the lab room that you could actually use too. Those are fair game too for the practical exam and all. So this is at 40x, all right? Really don't see much. That's the onion root, right? If you go closer, all right? That's at 100x. Getting closer, but not much. That's at 400. That's the level that you're going to see it at. All right? And you can definitely see certain things over there. There's that phase over here. When you get your microscope, you'll see it. But I want to step further. You guys don't do the oil immersion, but here's at 1,000. Phase is that? That's anaphase, sure. See how they're being pulled apart? Alright. If I give you something on the exams, it'll be like this. It's difficult what this one is, or that one. That looks more like prophase. This is maybe early, that's where you start getting into early, you know, anaphase or something. All right? But if I'm going to give you something on the exam, it'll be clear as day like that. Okay? Here's another one over here. What phase is that? Look at it closely. That's telophase. Look at the beautiful furrow there. That too is on my fireplace mantle. Oh, my house is wonderful. But anyway, there's the furrow. So it's not two cells completely. There's a furrow that's in between them. Okay? So that's our onion root. But you'll also have the opportunity to look at, oh, and there's another one too. Alright? Again, that's, what do you think that is? More like an anaphase, right? You really can't see the furrow there, but you definitely see that they're splitting. Okay? So the other one we have is the whitefish. Alright? And that's what it looks like at 40X. Really, you just are saying to yourself, WTF, I don't see anything, right? Okay, you're really not seeing anything, sure. But you gotta start. When you do microscope work, you always start from the lowest magnification and work your way up. So that's at 40X. That's at 100X. Still not seeing much. That's at 400. That's the level that you're gonna see it, alright? And you'll see certain things over here. But I want to step further, and I need to go immersion, and here it is at 1,000. What phase is this? See how they're all lined together like that in one straight line? Right? What's this? Yeah, that's metaphase again. Mm-hmm. Okay? Again, they're all in a straight line like that. Okay? What's that? That's how I'm going to give it to you, okay? I'm going to give it to you where it's really no question about it. I mean, if you can't pick out what that is, you know, just move on to the next question. That's pretty straightforward, okay? Questions about that? All right, so just to finish off mitosis, we've got cytokinesis. This is where it's a little bit different when we deal with animal versus plant cells. In animal cells, you got that cleavage furrow that happens more in telophase. Keep in mind, cytokinesis occurs as a last step in telophase. So there's still that furrow that you see, okay? And it forms this, what we call a contractile ring. So you're only looking at this as a two-dimensional thing. But keep in mind, this furrow is kind of like going around the whole cell. That's what the contracts, this ring is getting smaller and smaller until it pinches off. Alright, that's what that is. Alright, so that we have 50-50 on each. So that's basically how animal cells are. For plant cells, we got to form, remember, we've got the cell wall to deal with. So we have the cell plate that forms. And you have vesicles within the cell that move to the middle of the cell itself and coalesce, or kind of combine with each other. Alright? And the cell plate enlarges, and the two daughter cells will come out of there. So, yeah. So here's the animal cell. You got this. contractile ring, which is where the furrow is until it pinches off. And then you've got the cell plate forming. In between, it doesn't kind of, I wouldn't say pinch off, it doesn't contract, it's just forming basically from the center over here and goes up and down and forms the other two, or the two boys.
This soccer player's knee will be as good as new in a few weeks, thanks to mitosis, a type of cell division that generates new cells for growth and repair. Let's move into a cell to witness the events of mitosis. Before a cell can divide, it must first duplicate the chromosomes stored in its nucleus. During chromosome duplication, several bubbles open up along the chromosome. Each bubble grows until it merges with an adjacent bubble. Each chromosome now consists of two identical copies called sister chromatids. Getting closer, we see that each sister chromatid consists of DNA wound around small proteins called histones. The sister chromatids begin to coil into tight helical fibers. Outside the nucleus, centrosomes that duplicated earlier move away from each other to opposite sides of the cell. Microtubules extend from the centrosomes, forming the mitotic spindle. Back in the nucleus, the DNA forms loops, becoming more compacted. These structures fold back on themselves, eventually condensing into a shorter and thicker chromosome consisting of two sister chromatids. As the chromosomes continue to condense, the nuclear envelope breaks up. The array of spindle microtubules is now extensive, and the chromosomes are fully condensed. Spindle fibers from each pole attach to protein structures located at the centromere of each sister chromatid. As the chromosomes are bound by spindle fibers from opposite poles, they move first one way and then another. The counteracting forces of the spindle eventually cause all the chromosomes to end up at the center of the cell, as if arranged on an imaginary plate. The sister chromatids are released from each other, each becoming a full-fledged chromosome. They are moved toward opposite poles of the cell, pulled along the spindle fibers attached to them. At the same time, overlapping spindle fibers that are not attached to chromosomes continue to lengthen, pushing the poles farther apart. Once the chromosomes arrive at their destination, they become less condensed. Two new nuclear envelopes form, completing mitosis, the division of one nucleus into two genetically identical daughter nuclei. The cytoplasm divides by the process of cytokinesis, forming two separate daughter cells. In your body, millions of cells divide every second, providing new cells for growth and for repair of damaged cells.
Okay. Questions on this? That's mitosis. Is it? Compared to DNA replication, you got to say that's cakewalk. Right? Okay. All right, so binary fission. All right, so this is, I'll keep this short and sweet. Let's put a prokaryotic cells. And basically, you have bacteria and archaic organisms doing this. Basically, the chromosome replicates. The way that it replicates is that there's a point of origin. Keep in mind that it's not really a nucleus, it's really a nucleoid, right? Because there's no membranes around this. So it's going to be different. Like, there's no nuclear envelope, which I kind of showed you over here. So they do it kind of differently. But the two daughter chromosomes actually move apart. And basically you got this, see there's the origin, or there's the chromatin that's all in there, all the DNA information. There's some point where it's going to start duplicating. It's kind of like a, So you have a point of origin over here that kind of spreads out, so part of it is going to duplicate, it's going to start duplicating, and it's going to, two rubber bands, I don't have two rubber bands. But it's kind of like, if this is one rubber band, if you see this, it's going to start doing that kind of motion to turn it to two and then pinch off. But where it starts, where it's going to start duplicating, is called the point of origin. So it goes over there, splits into two, and you got two like that. It's simpler than mitosis. You don't have to worry about all those phases.